Today, pag-usapan natin yung supplements that you can take to fight double C. Double C stands for COVID and cancer. Ang COVID kasi is number one infection right now. And in fact, it was declared as pandemic. And cancer, kasi third na ang cancer ngayon as the leading cause of mortality. At the top two cancers right now are lungs and breast cancer. So again, this is Dr. Javison. Isa po akong internist and cardiologist to give you info video about supplements para we can fight the double C. Sabi nga ni Lindlar noong 1920s, you are what you eat. And it's time to focus now on the good and healthy stuffs that we eat. Because based on the data na lumalabas ngayon, yung COVID and cancer can penetrate your body because of a low immune system or very low antibody response. So that is why very important to strengthen. And in order to strengthen yung ating immune system, we need to have a good nutrition. Pag sinabing nutrition, we have to prevent undernutrition and overnutrition. So because 45% of patients, 45% of deaths worldwide is linked to undernutrition. Ibig sabihin, pag undernourished ka, you have a poor response to infection. At kahit bakunahan ka, hindi magde-develop ng antibody yung inyong katawan. And 1/4 of the population right now is overweight. And once you have obesity, nagkakaroon kang tinatawag na chronic inflammatory state. And this chronic inflammatory state will lead you to altered cellular immunity. In short, bababa ang inyong resistensya. That is why I want to talk today about the 5 supplements that you can take in order to prevent the double C. Ito yung COVID and cancer. So we have vitamins, we have the minerals, and then we have the melatonin, probiotics, and the beta-glucans. Kung narinig na ninyo yung beta-glucans, we will talk about beta-glucans as a way to prevent the double C. So sa vitamins, we have vitamin A, D, at E. So, ADE. So ikaw ba yung klase ng patient na laging lumalabo ang yung mata, yung paningin? And then you have dry eyes. Diba? We complain of dry eyes. And then, ikaw ba yung madaling mag-fracture? Konting ano lang, may fracture ka na sa bone, mababa yung immune system, and then, malagi kang may rashes sa skin. Laging nangangati yung balat, laging may acne. No? And then, may history ka ba ng cancer sa lungs or bladder, cervical, even lymphoma? So, perhaps, you lack vitamin A, and kung may history ang family ninyo with those kind of cancers, you need vitamin A in your body. Ang kagandahan lang, we have natural sources of vitamin A. And it can be in the form of provitamin A or preform active vitamin A. You can have vitamin A naman sa chicken, sa fish, sa dairy products like egg. Pero much better pa rin if you can get the provitamins sa plants. Provitamin A. And sa plants, ang important source ng vitamin A ay yung inyong sweet potato. So medyo na-overlook siguro ninyo na yung sweet potato nasa palengke lang yan, no? Nasa market lang yan. So you can have sweet potato available in your table. Aside from sweet potato, yung squash. Yung squash is also rich in vitamin A, so as yung carrots and lettuce for your salad. Sa fruits naman, your mango and grapefruit are the ones that are rich in vitamin A. One of the important vitamins naman is vitamin D. So, ikaw ba yung nagko-complain ng laging pagod? Yung feeling mo, tanghali pa lang, pagod na yung katawan mo. And then, masakit yung mga joints, masakit yung mga muscles. Sabi mo nga, masakit yung katawan mo the whole day. So, perhaps you need vitamin D supplements. One good thing with vitamin D, ang source niyan is sunshine. So, tropical country yung Philippines, so we have ample supply of sunshine. However, marami rin sa atin ang ayaw maarawan. So, you can get vitamin D from other foods that are fortified by vitamin D. And study showed na yung mga COVID patients are vitamin D deficient. So, ito yung mga studies na lumalabas from Europe. Mababa yung vitamin D levels ng mga patient na nagkaroon ng COVID. That is why we need to strengthen our immune system by taking vitamin D supplements and getting a lot of sun. Okay? So, maraming foods that are fortified with vitamin D. Pero natural source can be yung sardines, salmon, egg yolk, yung pula ng itlog. Mataas po yung level ng vitamin D na yan. Yung liver oil is also a good source ng vitamin D, and also mushroom can be a good source ng vitamin D. Next of the vitamins, yung A, D is vitamin E. So, do you have a muscle fatigue, weakness? So, kung meron ka mga feeling na ganyan, you need vitamin E supplementation because vitamin E is considered to be an antioxidant and can relieve any muscle weakness or fatigue. Yung vitamin E is the alpha tocopherol. So, meron siyang anti-aging properties and also protective ang effect niya when it comes to smoking and pollution. It repairs yung damaged cells. Alam niyo yung example na lang niyan, yung bike mo na hindi mo nagagamit, na nakastock lang dyan. Yung kotse mo na hindi mo ginagamit, di ba? Nagkakaroon ng kalawang, kinakalawang siya. So, to prevent that kind of scenario in humans, you need vitamin E to repair the damaged cells. So, ganun kaganda yung vitamin E in your body. So, saan mo makukuha yung vitamin E? Kung titingnan mo yung literature, usually sa nuts. So, you get a lot of nuts. Pero ang isang number one na mataas ang vitamin E are your sunflower seeds. So, you can buy yung sunflower seeds and take a snack of sunflower seeds. Another interesting ng vitamin E is they protect you from pollution and yung harmful effects ng smoking. So, you can get vitamin E sa avocado. Yan ang very rich in vitamin E. So as yung mga tomato, broccoli, salmon, at yung mangoes are rich in vitamin E. So yun yung tatlong vitamins na very important to fight the double C. Yung vitamin A, D, at E. Now we go to your minerals. So we have two minerals na identify na you need to be take a supplement. Number one is selenium and second is zinc. Ikaw ba yung type na laging puyat? Yung work mo is night shift or graveyard? Ikaw ba yung laging stress sa office? Yung pag andyan na yung boss mo, ayan na, yung stress levels mo, mataas na. Puyat palagi, you used to drink alcohol, smoking. Because these factors yung na-mention ko, can increase yung free radicals ninyo sa circulation. And ang ginagawa ng free radicals, it leads to oxidative stress. And kapag during oxidative stress, it increases yung risk niyo to develop cancer and heart conditions. So that is why you need selenium to fight this kind of conditions. In fact, selenium can also help you with your mental aging. So, nag-increase ng memory and focus. At the same time, if you have any thyroid or asthma condition, it can also help regulate your asthma and thyroid condition. An important source ng selenium will be your number one, winner talaga yung oysters when it comes to source of selenium. Yung iba, yung yellowfin tuna, eggs, and sardines, mga secondary winners na lang yan. Mas less yung kanilang oyster, yung kanilang selenium levels. And then you have zinc. Yung zinc naman, are you the type of person na laging may sipon, laging may rhinitis? pag natulog ka sa gabi, ayan na, sinusumpong na yung sipon mo, nahirapan ka na huminga. And sa madaling araw, nahirapan ka na rin huminga kasi inuubo ka na, sinisipon, at ikaw ba yung laging may sugat na hindi gumagaling? Yung mga may diabetes na laging may wound, laging may sugat, laging may rashes, ikaw ba yung laging siraan dyan? Every other day, every 3 days, or daily, meron kang diarrhea. Or you have CKD, ito yung chronic kidney disease, yung mataas yung creatinine levels due to some conditions. So you need, your body needs zinc. Yun nga lang, like selenium, our body doesn't produce zinc. That's why kailangan natin ng zinc as supplement. And once we have enough zinc, it will cover for our immune system. It will help in wound healing. It will also help in DNA synthesis. In fact, studies showed na less ang pneumonia, acne, when it comes to high levels of zinc. And in fact, may studies na zinc can improve your smell and taste. So kung may problem ka with your smell and your taste, you might be lacking in zinc in your body. So better check with your doctor. And ang better source ng zinc will be from animals and shells. So again, like selenium, ang source ng zinc will be from your shells and oysters, the mussels. Okay? Sa meat naman, this will be your beef and chicken. And then sardines, black beans, mushroom and cashew nuts are important sources of zinc. Next will be, ang fourth natin, or the third will be your melatonin. Maybe some of you are familiar with melatonin. When you go to your grocery, you can see maraming naka-label doon na melatonin as a supplement. Actually, yung melatonin is a very well-studied drug or supplements in science because it can really boost the immune system and can fight either bacteria, parasitic, and viral infection. So, ikaw ba yung laging may sakit? O yung laging absent sa office ninyo? Laging absent sa work? Pag-uwi ng bahay, hindi makatulog, stress, and then ikaw ba yung lagi nagta-travel ng different time zones, yung lagi may jet lag. So, kung na-identify ninyo yung sarili ninyo, and you're the right person para to take melatonin. Because as person ages, yung immune system natin bumababa. That is why this pandemic has caused a lot of older people na nagde-develop ng COVID. And also, older people are deprived of sleep. That is why melatonin is very beneficial for ages 60 and up. So, pag nag-senior ka na, malaki ang chance you need melatonin in your supplements. And melatonin also is linked to cancer. And yung mga people who works in night shift, yung deprived ng sleep, and those people with higher risk of developing cancer are advised to have supplement which can have melatonin in it. So, aside from supplement of melatonin, you can also get sources of melatonin from eggs, from fish, nuts, and mushroom. In fact, brown sugar, grapes, and strawberry, tomato soup, are rich in melatonin. But we have melatonin supplements already in the market. So you can have the 1 milligram or the 3 milligram melatonin. But I want you to seek consult with your doctor before taking any supplements kung safe ba sa inyo to take those kind of supplements. And yung fourth natin na supplement that you can take in order to fight the double C is probiotics. Ano ba yung probiotics? These are the microbes in the lower intestinal tract. Ito yung mga microbes that can help us digest, they can fight bacteria, and at the same time, it regulates our immune system. So you can take probiotics, yung mga natural way of having these probiotics. Probiotics are formed through fermentation. Kaya naman, yung once there's fermentation, there's production of probiotics, and these probiotics inhibit yung ACE enzymes. Yung ACE enzymes na yan, ito yung nagiging daan nung COVID para makapasok sa ating lungs. So, that is why very important na ma-inhibit yung ACE enzyme na yan. And probiotics can somehow inhibit that kind of enzyme. They block, binablock niya yung site of the ACE enzymes. That is why may mga studies ngayon na ginagamit yung probiotics in treating patients with COVID infection. And the source of probiotics na very rich, number one talaga dyan is yogurt. So yogurt and mga fermented vegetables, yung mga pickled vegetables. So you have pickled cabbage, di ba? Meron kang kimchi. Kimchi is very high in probiotics. So yung mga mahilig sa Korean food, di ba? Sa mga kimchi, magandang source siya ng probiotics. And last natin na source or last supplement that you can take to fight the double C is the beta-glucans. Have you heard yung nutraceuticals? So, yung nutraceuticals are the ones that provide relief sa mga patients with this kind of inventions, mga nutraceuticals. And may mga studies na rin na ginamit yung nutraceuticals against viruses. Ginamit na siya sa mga influenza, sa coronavirus, and very positive yung results because they provide relief to those patients infected with this kind of viruses. In fact, yung Mayo Clinic came up with a recommendation na you have to take 30 milligrams of beta-glucans a day. In fact, 3 grams lang ng soluble beta-glucans, yung mga oats, oat fiber a day, can not only increase your immune system, but can also lower your cholesterol levels by 5 to 10%. So may mga studies na siya. And in fact, kung ikaw yung type of person na laging may ubo, laging may sipon, constipated, yung laging nakakalimutan, ano nga ito? Ano na nga yun? So yung mga ganong klase, merong memory lapse, merong issues sa inyong blood sugar. So, you want to manage your weight, you need beta-glucans as a supplement. And where you can find beta-glucans, ito yung nakikita natin sa seaweeds, whole grains, oatmeal. So, kailangan nyo mag-breakfast ng oatmeal. Kung kaya nyo ito na half cup daily ng oatmeal, this is a good source of beta-glucans. And a bowl of barley soup, yung mga shiitake mushrooms, ito yung mga source of beta-glucans. And meron din mga supplements that most of them are imported na beta-glucans. Ask your doctors to be the source of your beta-glucans, no? So, those are our tips to fight the double C. Kailangan labanan natin with our situation right now. Kailangan natin labanan ng COVID at ang cancer. So, hope you learned from our info video. This is again Dr. Javison saying, the best gift that you can give to yourself and to your loved ones is the gift of health.